here on the block, man. Press Box Media in the building, bitch ass nigga.
I just started this.
Quit playing. That's the question, man. You back in here. We back in the lab, man. We back in the motherfucking box. This is the press box. This your boy, CA.
Yes, sir. I am your man, Spar Lane.
Man.
As you can see, we got a special guest, man. And
fucking special guest, man.
Hey, but check it out, man. We got to do me a favor before we even introduce the homie, man. Y'all know the routine, man. Go to the YouTube. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Share. Tell somebody, man. Chunk can do something when you see us on there, man.
Hey, man, let me also pay a couple of bills, you know, before we get started. So just pray. We got you. You see here. So we gonna get to him. You know what I'm saying? If you in the fashion world, you know what I mean? Business world, you know what I mean? There's a collab that I done. Some clothing, some gear. If you see me out, man, pull up on me. I got some positive vibe t-shirts. Hey, man. Nice quality, nice good. I also dropped some more new exclusive press box hoodies. You know what I'm saying? The new merch is here with no delay. It ain't on the way, it's here. You know what I'm saying? And I also got some other collabs coming up, man. So I just want y'all to understand that we is making the moves right now in real time. You know what I mean? Without any further ado, though.
Yes, sir.
Without any further ado, though.
Man, we got the long time old school homie with us, man.
Good partner.
You know, yeah. They go by the name Joe Weed.
Joe Weed.
In this day and age, you feel me? We're going to leave that at that, man. What's going on, bro?
Shit, same thing, different day, different year. You know, hopefully this is better than last year.
Ain't no doubt about it, man.
It's gonna be.
No doubt about it.
It's gonna be, man.
We been knowing you, bro, for damn, like I say, man, it's been over a decade. And we all met on a music vibe, you know, rapping, doing all this right here, man. Just before we get started, you tell us, or tell our people, man, who is Joe Weed and where you come from?
Man, I'm from all over the place, man. I moved around a lot, so I grew up in Freeport, you know, like in the Gulf.
Down south.
Yeah, down south. So I grew up down there for like probably like 5 years. That's where I was like raised at. And then came back like to Tyler.
Mm-hmm.
And then
I ain't met him
yet. I was still a little kid back then, you know, I was living in Tyler.
Was music a thing then as a kid or what you was just...
It's like, to me, it's always been there, you know? Like, I mean, I got a cover for a single album called Hard Time. Just me, like, as a little kid,
mm-hmm.
in front of, like, a turntable,
mm-hmm.
like some old school. This mm-hmm. wasn't 86.
You got that picture?
Yeah, why did they have a cover? So I mean, it's crazy because you know I didn't ever think of it, but it was like, you know, my pops, whenever I grew up, my dad, he was on some whole other shit.
Mm-hmm.
So like, we live, was moving around, friends and family, homeless type. Couch type shit, you know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? They end up going back with my granny, me and my mom and my sister, so.
What granny is?
She down the road. She out here in East Texas.
That's all I want to hear right there.
Yeah,
East
Texas.
Is he gonna rip or what?
But you know what I'm saying? So we stationed out here in East Texas, you know, it's been a process, you know. We moved around, you know what I'm saying? I was down here for some years, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm staying down here.
So. He's talking about
in Henderson, man.
That's what I bet it.
Fuck around, you know, see Joe Weed every day.
Yeah, that's what I bet
it. We started out all over the place, man, you know what I'm saying? And then it really just came about doing work. Staying busy, man. That's where it come from, and getting settled down in certain places. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Having to go back to your roots and seeing what you really can offer, man, and what do people need? You know what I mean? And,
man, I'm gonna say this, like, okay, even though we ain't got to today,
mm-hmm.
I think the people should at least know. Then, you know what I'm saying? You way more than a one-stop shop. No, you are basically a one-stop shop when it comes to, quote-unquote, the industry shit with this music and shit, because it ain't too many things, me personally, that I know about you that you don't do, man. Like I say, when I first met you, you know what I'm saying, as far as the engineering, the graphics, anything to do with that computer, man, and rapping too, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't too much you were doing. But during that phase of
I was trying to rap back then. It was, you know what I'm saying? But I wouldn't even say that it was still just trying to find myself. You know what I'm saying? Because it's what you talk about, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's like everybody can rap metaphors, punchlines, and do all that. You know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? Make up some shit. But like when you really trying to promote a message, you gotta really know what you're talking about. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You don't wanna put the wrong message out or play a character. You know what I'm saying? You want to be yourself, you know what I'm saying? So when everything comes out, you know what I'm saying? You're not playing some role that you don't know what you're into. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, it's just business, you know what I'm saying? But it's also relationships that are personal based. You know what I mean?
So saying that you took the stuff as in back then, you said you was learning your path.
With the rapping part, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was doing the beats and the engineering and the graphics, you know what I'm saying? And mm-hmm. the photos and the videos and all that stuff.
Which is a job in itself. It's a whole lane in itself for that.
Yeah, well, every one of those is its own lane. Yeah. Like, I know we were talking the other day about, like, who would be one of the people that we could have been if we wasn't who we were.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, well, you need a DJ. Well, I said,
that's
a DJ,
what I said. I had known back then what I know now.
Yeah, it could be a DJ, but you know, you got to have at least a good 5 different people with you to really build your network and your foundation that's going to help you be who you are.
But you got to keep in mind, even back when we all was linking up doing our thing, we had enough people for everybody.
But it was everybody, it was like we was all trying to do everything ourselves.
For the most part, everybody wanted to be a rapper.
Yeah, everybody wanted to be a rapper, but it was also like certain people didn't want to learn to do this. They would learn to do this because they would see some money coming from that. But the thing that was going to make the most money was going to take a little bit longer to learn.
And I tried to teach everybody.
That's like, yeah. I mean, I tried to teach everybody.
You taught me how to engineer.
A little bit of something.
I mean, I probably wasn't the best before, you know.
But it give you some idea of how to progress and know how to fix it and be like, oh, I need to change this a little bit. It give you more of a how to check and check some, I guess you would call it checks and balances, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's the, you always got to check yourself, man, you know, that's the goal. Is make sure you don't, because there's a bunch of steps. If you miss some steps, you know, like trying to do it yourself, I mean, it's not a problem to ask anybody.
No.
It's just being able to ask somebody
right.
if you don't know. You know what I'm saying? So that's where it starts too.
Don't be so on your motherfucking horse that you can't be like, hey man, I don't know, I need some help.
Yeah, bro. I mean, sometimes it's just be like, man, how would you do this?
You know,
I got this coming. What you think you should do this? I mean, if it was you coming from that, and it's y'all would be like, shit, man, I don't know this, but I know this. But
okay,
shit. Well, we need to, like you said earlier, outsource.
Especially in the time we in now, where the click of a button, you can find who you need to find is doing what you need.
Yeah.
It wasn't always like that.
No,
when you could just go on the internet and say, I need to find somebody to do graphics, you know what I'm saying?
But that's how a lot of that happened, you know, with this social media, because the online presence is something else too, you know what I'm saying? Because it's like we was talking about the network. You can't just pick up your house phone and call the UK, your phone bill or wherever, like, I can't call Dirty Ray over in overseas, you know what I'm saying?
Because we like got a block on all long-distance calls for the house phone, no bullshit.
I think Dirty Ray's in Japan.
That's your people. I'm just saying, your people, you global.
Because I can't say nobody I know in Japan.
I don't talk to nobody.
And we do music together, so I mean, it's...
That's your people then.
It's easier for me to hit him on IG or Facebook.
Than it is to hit that, you know, 17 number trying to dial.
Yeah, or running up a $1,700 phone bill.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because,
that
I mean,
it's a lot different. But also... It can take away from your craft.
He's in Tokyo. I know that's where he's at. He's in Tokyo.
So we're going to get to what he's saying now. Y'all hear what he's saying? UK, Japan. We're going to get to the global shit. But that's it.
But like, just specifically like that, like, he uses a translation app.
To talk to you?
Yeah.
To know what the hell you're saying. So do you use the same thing? Know what he's talking about?
No, because he already translated.
Oh, I got you.
Like, so he'll translate, I guess. That's what he told me.
Gotcha.
I just, you know what I'm saying? So that's something how that goes, you know, if.
Well, then, since we're going to build on this right here, now, let's just go on and get to this part then. Since you want to talk about Japan,
get to Tokyo.
How do you get from, you know, Palestine to Henderson to all around Texas, and now you got people global? How did you get global like this?
How the hell?
It's really just good business, bro. That's really all it is. You know, it's just good business. And then how you go about it. You know what I mean? It's a difference whenever.
When you say good business, do you mean putting it like y'all going on missions together? When I say missions, as far as like motherfucker might need
to
be.
Dirty Ray just an example of like how far you can reach out. You know what I mean? Like I don't talk to him every day or anything like that. You know what I'm saying? It's just like that's an example of like how far you can reach with the media. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like there's really no extent to it. But like when you're talking about like good business, you know, that's just like y'all need something done, and it's, you know what I mean?
If you say you're going to have it on a Wednesday, then you're going to have it on a Wednesday. You're going to meet the deadlines and the requirements.
You might have it early, you know what I'm saying? You might
come on, that's what I was trying to get out of it.
It's more of just being truthful, you know what I'm saying? If you know it's going to take you a month, which I don't know what takes a month, but...
If it is.
You know, if it takes a month, you say that it's going to take a month, and if it's going to be this and that, or you want this and that, you know?
That's just, what everything is, making your word your bond.
Yeah.
To keep your business going, because
but that's like, well, a lot of people mess up by asking how much for this. That's the one thing I'll say.
Putting a price on it.
Well, if you really got to ask how much it is, you can't afford it, bro.
Well, I mean, it's really, you would really say, man, I'm looking for a quote on how much it's going to cost to see if I got enough money for it. So you don't just disrespect off the muscle by not even replying back to when they tell you how much.
Mm-hmm. You deal with that.
I've had to deal with that.
You been on both sides of that?
Well, I mean... There's a lot of business.
I'm just saying, because you at one point in time, I'm sure you done reached out to a motherfucker, and they looked at that shit and just was like, I ain't even responding. But then
you also get a estimate on kind of what people are looking for. You know
exactly
what I'm saying? If you reach out to one person and you know that they're a substantial artist, you know what I'm saying? That they got a name for themselves and they're doing something, you're going to want to.
Have your shit together.
Yeah.
That goes along with your reputation. You know, if you got a reputation for not doing what you say you're going to do.
All the time that you say the good business.
Or having your split sheets right, too, whenever you're doing that type of business, too. Because
what the hell is a split sheet?
Slow down. Come on, you slid that in, split sheet.
So it's just like BMI, ASCAP, percentages, ownership, registration numbers, breakdowns, all the... It's pretty much the paperwork. You know, that starts out right there. You start out getting it registered up, right? Which you go through your distributor, if it's DistroKid, TuneCore, CD Baby, whatever it is. United Masters.
Let me ask you this then, because you're talking real big business shit now, man, that a lot of artists that maybe been in the game for a long time, or you might just now be getting in the game. That's some pertinent information that people should know. So if we did have an artist or anybody that could be listening to this right now, and they hearing this, they saying, well, man, I really want to, you know, get my music on these platforms, or I want to figure out how to get my music global, or what is my BMI ASCAP? Could you offer services or what you call it, consultations?
No, I don't offer that.
Would you do a consultation if somebody say, man, I want to know this? And you say, well, I know it.
But it's gonna cost
you this amount for hours for me to run it out through that.
I mean, it's not like, I mean, it's seriously, it's that basic. I mean, I just told you what you gotta do. You just take, if you're doing it yourself and you're independent and you're putting it out through your own distributor, unless I think besides CD Baby, if they're doing your publishing type stuff for you, if you're doing the independent publishing and you're doing all your registrations, you're the one recording, mixing, mastering, getting all the stuff, paying for everything. You go EWC on BMI 200%.
Believe me, I know.
Which is the writer's credits, which is pretty much giving ownership to the writers.
Check me out. I know what you're saying. You just told me that, but we was having a personal conversation before the camera got on. So I know you'd get that to me, but we know the game is sold, it ain't told. So if you got some information, that's another way to monetize the game. Of course, you may.
Well, this is public information.
Everything is public information. All you gotta do is Google shit, but people don't. They lazy to Google. I'm gonna add my boy Joe, man, to give me the game, man.
Yeah.
Cause we got to monetize this shit. Because, like I say, you sitting up here sitting on a wealth of information.
Like a motherfucker. That nigga always have it.
Yeah, but no, man, it's that simple. You know, getting your registrations right. You know what I'm saying? Taking care of that. And, you know what I'm saying? Just sharing your music. You know, staying interacting. It's gonna start out with people that's close to you, but it can expand very fast. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Because it's more of a who likes your music. You don't know.
I was looking at your Instagram the other day, and you were posting your stream status. You got like millions.
That's just over time. That's not even. That's like this last
the,
year.
This the only person I know personally that can show me a million streams on the internet, though. I mean, that says a lot about.
Nah, this maybe around here, maybe in,
that
maybe,
I know
maybe,
personally.
Maybe in independently, that seems like a lot, but it's really not.
Well, that a million anything is a lot to me now.
No, that's not though. It's not. That's just the truth of it. It's not.
Well, I wish I knew what that million streams felt
like. Over the time, you know what I'm saying? Over the time frame that it pays you out, it's not. Because it's over the amount of time. Yeah. It's like you're not even seeing that all at once.
I could dig that too. There's still a lot of people that's done tapped into your music.
So we
know you've been doing all of the things that behind the scenes, like we were saying, the producing, the graphics, the engineering, all this right here. At what point did you say,
I'm going to take my music serious, like real serious. Because you can tell the jump, if they looking at the, they can tell the flow. It transitioned from, you got a lot fucking better. Let's just be cut and dry with
it. Yeah, it's not even, it's just like I say, it developed over time, you know, and actually doing these songs with these other guys, like, you know what I'm saying, D. Gotti and
Les. That's the intro song y'all just heard. Who was that on there?
D. Gotti.
Come on, man.
Yeah, the 80
and
Bars.
And what is called?
80 Bars.
80 Bars. Yeah. If you're on YouTube, in the YouTube world, check it out right now. Joe Weed and D. Gotti. 80 Bars, man.
So we're talking about, you know what I'm saying, some of your constituents, comrades. Who else have you collabed with that we might know?
People, I mean, shit. Got D. Gotti, ESG, Gotti got a track together, it's coming soon, got a special feature, I'll tell y'all about that later, but that's for me and Gotti got something in the works, ESG on that project also.
I seen something with Lester Roy.
Yeah, I got something with Lester, Mr. Master Archie Lee, man, Magno. Man, it's a lot of stuff. Man, I won't even leave nobody out, bro. It's a lot of people, man.
I was just saying that to say that your networking game
Flip, took off. Kiki.
Your networking done took off, too, to where, you know what I'm saying, your name's right there amongst some of the well-known people when it comes to records out right now, or projects out right now.
Yeah, we got some new stuff coming, too, though, that
it's plugged in into your shit?
No, that's Gotti shit. That was something that we working on together. He got that work in the mix.
Have you started the label?
Yeah, I've been working on Texas Digital, man. That's like the main focus. What I was working on, and it's more of like some mixtape type stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, bringing artists together. You know, and help break artists and stuff that I've been working with a long time and helping them get all their stuff together. You know what I mean? Just like, if I was to get you on a song, to make sure you got all your stuff right. So right you don't get paid for right what on. I'm doing, which in turn is probably, once you start seeing that, you're going to be like, man, I need to go on and do something else. And it'll just help motivate people when they get their paperwork right.
I was motivated. Like I say, you jumped on my live, and we just started chopping up the other day until we hear it now. Uh-huh. But like I was saying, when I seen them streams, and I'm steady watching everything you're doing, I'm like, God damn, this motherfucker ain't never stopped. You know what I'm saying?
Since back then.
But that's like a lot of that streams, bro. That's like, I can pull up, that's from playlists. Like being on adding, other, making good music. You know what I'm saying? Because you don't know who's going to, like I said, who's going to like your music. But whenever it goes out, they add it to their playlist or whatever they got it on. Like I said, I think I'm on over like 4,000 playlists.
God.
That's lit. Damn. That's lit.
So
that's lit.
People listen to you every day. You know,
what's your catalog like, man? I mean, it's, that you're a part of.
Song, I got about 150 tracks out myself.
It's good work.
I've took part in a lot of songs too, you know, a lot of stuff, some features and, you know, help put another artist stuff together. I've done that, you know, and that's a whole process in itself. It's a difference in, you know, being your own artist and being an artist or a label and still trying to, because you got to take care of yourself first. That's the one thing. If you can't take care of yourself,
how you gonna help somebody else?
Yeah, and it's just about just telling them the information, because that's what everybody wants to know.
Yeah.
Question. Give me your top five all time rap. They ain't even gotta do that. Give me your top five artists all time.
Dead, live, we don't care about none of that. If you can do a song with dead,
that's the difference. No, we ain't talking about that. That ain't what I had.
Okay.
If y'all top five, yes.
Top five artists.
I can't pick five. I couldn't even pick 10 or 15, bro. I'm gonna be honest. I probably couldn't even pick 50. Because I'm listening to three artists that I grew up on, like
your favorite motherfucking people you like.
I would say Screw. And it's hard to say that because
damn, I'm gonna tell you something.
Would you classify Screw? Because when you think of that, bro, I'm just being honest, because whenever you listen to Screw, bro, it had everybody, bro.
And he really stole one of my amps.
But that's the truth, though.
Hey, I ain't never said that, but that's the king of the South, no doubt about it. The greatest of all time.
It just, to where I was living, that's what came through, you know what I'm saying? Because it was the first, like, man, you gotta listen to this. It was like, got everybody on it. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, what?
It really do got everybody. You know what I'm saying?
So it was like, you couldn't even
do it. Did he mix in other songs?
Yeah, like, but you wouldn't, and you would be like, man, what is that? Who is that? Yeah. Oh, I've heard that one. Screw introduced us
to a whole.
Yeah, bro, so I can't pick a top like that, bro. Like, if you want, I could pick one, bro. That's
So I guess if I ask you this, if you had an opportunity to work with one artist, you would be on the Screw tape.
Man, that would be awesome. Wow. I know.
Shout out
DJ Red, Screwed Up Records and Tapes, man. He do all my Slow and Child projects, bro. And like I say, it's Slow and Child, bro.
What would your tape be called? You know how he had named it. You know what I mean? If you fuck with Screw that hard, I know you done thought of the tape name before and been like, man, my tape would have been called
Coming Dying in the Country.
Real shit.
Yeah, that'd be dope.
Real shit. All right, let's take it from you was talking about artists and putting out artists. What about you still doing mixtapes?
Well, I mean, not necessarily mixtapes. You know, we doing like cypher projects. They're original beats and stuff like that, but. You know, they got major features, independent features, underground, all that.
But you still building the bridge between the major.
Yeah. It's a process, man. Like I say, even just getting the paperwork right for that type of stuff, so people understand that that's how it's supposed to be done.
Yeah.
Because long term, who knows what can happen.
Facts.
So, I mean.
Facts.
And this is just about, like I say, making sure everything's right, bro. Whenever you got your split sheets and, you know what I'm saying, your release forms and everything like that, it's basic business.
Mm-hmm. Well, like, it makes sense to do business with Joe because he got all this right here. So no matter if it don't even go right and then it fuck around and go right.
Yeah, you never
then
know.
With Joe covered, I'm covered.
But it's also about trying to do your best to create a good song, bro. It's not just going to the studio. Sometimes nowadays you can go to the studio and spend $200-$300 on a single. Mm-hmm. Just studio time. If you go to the studio and try to write it in the studio, that's already.
That's another hour or two.
You know what I'm saying? So, but that's a mistake, I would say.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Not going prep to the studio, you know, so that's one start.
Well, you that's a lot, and I'm going to tell
beats
you.
Beats tracked out, ownership, no leases, no YouTube beats, having all that ready. Depending on your quality, what you want, you know what I mean? If you're just trying to put some stuff together to put out and test the waters, I mean, that's cool, but if it blow, now you got to go back.
And backtrack everything. Yeah. So anything that you've gained.
And I ain't even saying I've had nothing blow. You know what I'm saying? It's just like I say, over time, you know, this stuff adds up. But it's also about owning that stuff. Because when the checks start getting offered or deals get offered and checks start coming, you know, you want to have everything.
To where it's leading
up. Yeah, to where it's like, okay, I actually own my music. I can see it. Where it's coming in.
Mm-hmm.
So just monetize yourself.
Let me ask you this. Where did Joe Weed come from? Now, you got to break this down. Where did Joe Weed come from? How you come up with that?
Man, the homie. Man, we was smoking all the time. We always smoke weed, man.
Little Reggie. No. Oh, my bad. Okay.
My fault.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay. Yeah.
No Reggie, you see.
Oh,
okay.
Shout out Algiers.
Okay.
And Trill, he's a Leo. Trill Gear, but he's Leo, man.
Yeah.
Man, I was just in the studio, man, and you know, everybody just like roll up. I was always in the studio working, so everybody come through, leave some weed, you know what I'm saying, whatever, roll up, smoke, da-da-da, whatever. Shit. I be in that bitch working so long, I smoke my weed, his weed, and your weed. And they were like, that's what happened. The homie came in, and he was fucked up. He said, yo, weed, you smoked all my shit.
Straight up. Yeah. And it stuck.
It just stuck.
Go on, just pull me out of retirement one time. Let me get a little BMI play. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Just one time. You know what I'm saying? But I will say this man did tell me, about 2 years ago, like, hey man, got something you can jump on. I sat around and waited to the last minute. I missed the boat on that one, but you call me this time, I'm gonna go on and get on top of my game, man.
Hey man, it's just another day. It's just another day, man. We're gonna get to it, man. It's just make your phone calls, what you gotta do, and we'll get it right on the muscle.
Shit, man. I want y'all to go. In our audience, man, our people, I ain't gonna say fans, our family, man, where can these people find you on everywhere? All digital shit, every social site, where they find you at? Under what?
Joe Weed on Spotify and iTunes, any other digital streaming platform. I am Joe Weed on IG, Joe_Weed420 on Twitter. I don't really be on Facebook like that. Snapchat, none of that shit. No. You hit me on, check me out on IG, check out the music, man.
On the ground, go stream some of that music.
IG and Twitter, man. Mm-hmm.
You got your YouTube channel?
Yeah, Joe Weed on YouTube, man.
Go subscribe some videos on there, man. Check Joe Weed on YouTube, man. Y'all go subscribe, man. And click that bell so you know when he come out. You say he's got that Charlie Bar coming out, man. Third quarter next month, man. What you gonna give us some closing words, man? What you gonna leave us with for us, man, to take out with this 2021, man?
Man, everybody stay safe, be humble. You know, shit, it be times you be wanting to act the ass in public because you see somebody doing something you don't agree with.
Thanks.
You know what I'm saying? It's always shit. Just people drive slow on the road. It's, you know what I'm saying? People taking their time nowadays, man. So you can't really... Don't upset yourself over stuff you can't control.
Thanks.
You know what I'm saying? And just be aware of what is going on, man.
Pay your fucking attention.
Yeah,
man. That's
it.
It'll come to you.
Just be aware, bro. And be safe.
Hey, man. Y'all be safe.
Yeah.
As you can be, man.
Hey, but check this out, Joe. You got to come back, man, chop some little game with us, man. No problem, and kind of keep us posted. Because all the game that you told me off the camera, we're going to figure out a way to work that in, you know what I'm saying? But we didn't want to give them all that at one time.
It's just basics, man. It's just you got to know the basics.
He keeps saying shit is basic when he been doing it for all this time. But for somebody that's kind of green to it, you know what I'm saying? It's a little bit more complicated until you walk me down.
I understand that. I mean, that just goes to YouTube. You know what I'm saying? You can get everything on YouTube, man. I ain't gonna lie. YouTube helped me out a lot.
YouTube University.
YouTube U.
Big old facts.
I'm saying, man. YouTube U. 2020.
Hey,
you could have got it in this year. You could have damn near graduated.
Facts, man. PhD.
I'm just being honest.
I got a doctorate, man. You know what I'm saying? But listen, man, this is the Press Box, man.
Press Box.
Yes, thanks, y'all, for tuning in. Man, we look forward to bringing in this 2021, man, in a real major way. Shout out to the homie, man, Joe Weed, for coming through, man, because this might be the last interview we do in this 2020, man. So y'all be on the lookout.
Man, you ain't got but, like...
Huh?
Yeah. Shit, like 2 days.
We got two, three days.
Two, 3 days, man. Understand this, the Press Box. Hey, man, we moving forward, man. Say, man, y'all get down with us. Hit subscribe, like, share. It's that easy, man. Appreciate you.
We out here.
Out here on the block, man. Press Box Media in the building, bitch ass nigga.